verse 7, and who shall descend into the deep, that is to bring up Mashiach from the dead. Verse 8, but what saith it? The word is nigh thee, even in thy mouth and in thy heart. That is the word of faith that we preach. That is the word of faith, which is the law, the commandments, the prophets, revelation. These are all things that have been commanded unto you so-called black, Hispanic, and Native Americans. That we are the real Jews, the Israelites that the Bible speaks of. Now this is talking about the whole book, not just the New Testament. God does not love everybody. He will return for his elect, for you so-called black, Hispanic, and Native Americans, in the midst of World War III, with the chariots that you call UFOs. These are the chariots of the Heavenly Father. And they will come and beam up his elect from off this land, right before the nuclear missiles hit Babylon the Great. So this is that word of faith that we're supposed to reach unto our people and let them know, reveal these things. This is part of publishing the truth to the one-third of the nation of Israel. This is the book of Romans, chapter 4 and verse 3. Because again, it says the word of faith. Now you have to have faith before you execute your works. You have to believe that we are the Israelites. You have to keep the commandments and believe that you will keep them unto the best of your ability. You have to believe that Yahweh Mashiach, who the world calls Jesus Christ, you have to believe that is a true name. Because that's what it was written for our learning, for us to understand. And to know the Heavenly Father's name, which is Yahweh, not Jehovah, not God. These are all false titles. His name is Yahweh. This is Romans chapter 4 and verse 3. For what saith the scripture? Abraham believed God, and it was counted unto him for righteousness. So he believed, and then he showed his faith with his works. Now, this is verse 10. How was it then reckoned when he was in circumcision or in uncircumcision? Not in circumcision, but in uncircumcision. So, the Lord of our fathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, he appeared unto Abraham and commanded him to come out from the lands of his people, which was in the land of Iran, Mesopotamia, which you would call the Fertile Crescent. So he called our father out of that land, Abraham, and he believed that. So you have to believe first, and then you have to show your works. Now this that I read in Romans chapter 4 and verse 10, this is essentially saying that this happened before any covenant was made, before circumcision was commanded. So our father Abraham believed. This is why we're out here to you so-called black, Hispanic, and Native Americans, and making known the understanding of the scriptures and the biblical prophecies of the Holy Bible. So he was given it in uncircumcision, meaning before he was given the covenant, because he had to believe and then show his belief through the execution of his works. This is Romans chapter 4, verse 21. And being fully persuaded that what he had promised, he was able also to perform. So you have to be fully persuaded in his truth. This is what we're all here to do. Fully persuade you so-called black, Hispanic, and Native Americans. Do your archaeology. Do your biblical prophecies. Thus saith the Holy Bible. That you have to repent and return back unto the Heavenly Father. Do the word of faith, which was preaching unto you. Like our father Abraham, he believed. And then he showed his belief through his works. Now what was commanded to us is our keeping of the law. This is our righteousness, like it says in the law, in the book of Deuteronomy. Which Deuteronomy means second law in the Paleo Hebrew. Now this is the book of Sarah, chapter 44, verse 20. Says the book of Sarah, chapter 44, verse 20. Abraham was a great father of many people, and glory was there none like unto him. Verse 20, who kept the law of the Most High, and was in covenant with him. He established the covenant in his flesh. When he was proved, he was found faithful. So the Heavenly Father is proving us today through our sacrifice, through us coming out on the highways and byways, letting our people know the truth and the understanding of the scriptures and prophecies, things that have to come to pass. Now, this, from beginning unto the end, it will tell you the same thing concerning the Holy Bible. What the children of Israel, you so-called Black, Hispanic, and Native Americans are commanded to do. This is Genesis, chapter 26, and verse 5. This is Genesis 26, verse 5. Because thou, Abraham, obeyed my voice, and kept my charge, my commandments, my statutes, and my laws. So Father Abraham, he kept the commandments, he kept the laws and the statutes that was commanded by the Heavenly Father. Through his ministers, which are the messengers, the prophets. Now, this is Deuteronomy, chapter 30, and verse 10. If thou shalt hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to keep his commandments and his statutes, which are written in this book of the law, and if thou turn unto the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul. Verse 25. For this commandment which I command thee this day, it is not hidden from thee, neither is it far off. Why? Because we have the scriptures, which tells us what has to happen unto this land, unto Babylon the Great, what will happen to two-thirds of our people, the majority who do not repent and return back to their nationality, which we are Israelites, that the Bible speaks of, the real Jews, not those Khazars that are in the land of Israel today, and you Arabs that are in the all holy land. We are the true Israelites that the Bible speaks of. So it is not afar off, verse 12. It is not in heaven that thou shouldest say, who shall go up for us to heaven, and to bring it unto us, that we may hear and do it. Neither is it beyond the sea that thou shouldest say, we shall go over the sea for us, and bring it unto us, that we may hear and do it. Verse 14, that the word is very nigh unto thee, in thy mouth and in thy heart, and thy word is with the law, with the prophets, the heard book, and the revelation, which is the last book, things that still have to come to pass. This is 1 Kings, chapter 11, verse 33. 1 Kings 11 and 33. Because that they have forsaken thee, and they worship Asherah, the goddess of the Sidonians, which are the Hamites, so-called Africans, and our people, the Judites, our brothers and Negroes, are not the same as the Africans. These are two distinct groups of people. You have the Chinese man and you have the Japanese man. These are two different, distinct group of people. Now, it reads, Chemosh, the god of the Moabites, which the Moabites biblically are the so-called Chinese. You can see that if you look it up in archaeological documents. And Malcolm, the god of the children of Ammon, which is the so-called Japanese, according to the Bible, according to archaeology. Thus saith the scriptures. And had not walked in my ways to do that which is right in my eyes, and to keep my statutes and my judgments, as did David his father. So this is why people run off. We've been defiled by these idols, by philosophy, by religion, Christianity, Catholicism, which are based off of falsehood. So again, it reads 2 Judges 16 and 36. Second Judges 16 and verse 36. Behold, the word of the Lord, Yahweh, receive it. Believe not the gods of whom the Lord spake. Verse 37. Behold, the plagues draw nigh and are not slack. Verse 68, for behold, the burning wrath of a great multitude is kindled over you, and they shall take away certain of you, and feed you being idle with things offered unto idols. So again, so-called white man knows that his time is short. Your other nations know that this land is finished. So it says that they take some of us and feed us unto things that were offered unto idols, unclean food. This is talking about internment camps. This is talking about the brand of the beast, Revelation chapter 13. Most High Yahweh is going to deliver a lot of you other nations to the sword. And the two-thirds of our people. Why? Because we've been defiled by these false ways of thinking. Verse 69, and they that consent unto them shall be had in derision, and in reproach, and trodden underfoot. Verse 70, for there shall be in every place, and in their cities, a great insurrection upon those that fear the Lord. So those that know they are Israelites, that are keeping the commandments, there's going to be an insurrection upon those by the so-called white man to assist him. And it's going to happen in every city, and it will come to pass. Now that insurrection is talking about internment camps, Revelation 13, the mark of the beast, the microchip. That is the mark of the beast. The mark of the beast is not something spiritual. It is an actual mark that this man will put in you in order to claim you as his property. And he's doing that slowly through his legislation. Verse 71, they shall be like madmen, sparing none, They're still spamming and destroying those that fear the Lord. So they will be like madmen, because they know that the time is short and they won't be able to finish their counsel. They won't be able to put in the new world order, which is the new world order is actually what you would call in the past the Tower of Babel. Or Babel, when the other nations are gathered, building the tower, opposing the Heavenly Father. So these things are not going to happen, just like the Tower of Babel was cast down. And we're doing that through the word of Yahweh Hashem Yahashah. This is why we give the double honors to the elders and apostles of great wisdom. They are the true teachers for the nation of Israel on earth today. And we're not here for all you so-called black, Hispanic, and Native Americans. We're here for the elect. We're here to let you know you are the sons of the power, the sons of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Jacob, his name has changed to Israel. We are the children of the power. We have to repent, come back to the Heavenly Father, keep his commandments, believe in the Yahweh Shah Mashiach. This is why we pray to the Heavenly Father, Yahweh, Bashem, Yahushua. That is in the plural of Hebrew, the ancient Hebrew, meaning Yahweh, in the name of Yahushua. Thus saith the Heavenly Father. Now, so this is what the Bible says has to come to pass, and will come to pass in these last days before Jacob's trouble, which is also the trouble of the other nation. Because Esau, the so-called white man, he will come up against all people of the earth and try to issue his mark, according to Revelation chapter 13, which is a chip. It says, 2 Angels, chapter 16, 15, and verse 29, where the nations of the dragons of Arabia shall come out with many chariots, and the multitude of them shall be carried up as the wind upon the earth, that all they which hear them may fear and tremble. This is talking about Iran. The other Arab nations in the Middle East, the Russians, the Chinese, they're coming up upon this land through their military power, the ICBM missiles. This is biblical prophecy. These things will come to pass. 2 Angels 15 and verse 30. Also, the Cormanians, which are the Persians, which is modern-day Iran. You look it up. These are facts that we're speaking. Raging and wrath shall go forth as the wild boars of the world. And with great power shall they come and join battle with them. So their great power is the backing of these great military powers, like Russia, like China, coming up against Babylon the Great to destroy it. Which is also spoken in the book of Revelation. Now, get that precept. It says Revelation